Everyone, Amanda Christina here. I'm doing a tutorial today on how to make your own hand beaded Mickey ears. Aren't these gorgeous? Try and hold them where the camera can see them. I made these the other day. There's also a photo on my Instagram. I made these watching the Thingamavlogs DisneyCon marathon live stream where they raised over $15,000 for charity for the Pavlov Foundation. So, I have some stuff I prepared earlier just to make this go quicker. Now, this same technique for wrapping the headband for this can be used on these cute little kitty ears. The only difference is I wrap both the ears individually or together and then I come and do the headband. That's the only difference, but it is basically the same wrapping technique. These headbands were bought cheap off eBay. You can get them for about a dollar. I do not like what they come in, so I changed it and did my own version and put some ribbon and some flowers on them just to really give them a zhuzh. So the first thing you need is you're going to need a headband, or a headband, but we don't need either of those right now. Some ribbon, which I have cut mine already to the pieces I need, which I'll explain to you when we get there. I am using pearls, but you can use whatever round beads you want. The reason I have some already done is I just wanted this tutorial to go a little quicker. So what we're going to do to start with is make your wire loop. Now, this is so easy. You're going to absolutely die laughing when you find out how easy this technique is. It is one of the easiest things to do. So we've just got a nice big thing of wire. I got this for 75 cents off Blitzy last year. So I'm just going to, that should be about enough. So I'm just going to snip it with, now make sure you don't use your scissors for wire. Make sure you have wire snippers because you will ruin your scissors. Now, what you're going to do is you straighten it out a bit because this is a bit wonky. And we're going to take the wire. I did cut way too much, but you also do want extra wire. And there is a good reason for this. You want extra wire so that at the end of this, you can use that wire to wrap it onto your headband. So we're just making sure this is in the right spot, and then we're just going to do, now we're not going to twist this together yet, we're going to do a twist and up. So you've got it here and you just twist and up and you just make sure that this is nice and sort of mostly all shaped nicely, and then you're going to pull it off, undo your little undo one of your twists, so you want it, and it doesn't matter if you lose a bit of shape at this point, because what will happen is that when you will reshape these again. I have ways where I reshape some of mine. So then you just take your pearls. These are just plastic pearls I got off eBay. They're kind of off-white. So you take your pearls. You literally, I don't even know how well you're seeing this because these are so tiny, but you're literally just putting the pearls over the wire. And this is part of the reason that I have a couple of steps already done, because I didn't want to sit here and make this a super long tutorial. As you all know, I'm no good at editing videos. I have no technical skills or technical know-how, and when I try, it makes me cry and gives me migraines. So basically what you're going to do is thread them onto your wire, and you do that, we'll do a few more just to show you, but like literally you just do that until your whole ear, well yeah, your whole circle is covered. It's just finding the little holes. Sometimes it's easier than others, and sometimes you put your finger over the holes because, you know, that happens. And this is super easy. If you've got one of those beading boards where you just lay out your beads, that would probably be a really quick way to do this. This is a really fun thing to do while you're watching TV. It's quite relaxing. So there you go. That's sort of your first little lot of beads. Hang on, I'll put my hand there so you can see them. And then what you do is when you're done, you measure against whatever size you actually want to be. And I've kind of moved this a little off center It doesn't really matter. And then you literally just twist. You do a twist and then you keep twisting. And then you just literally take your thumb and forefinger and twist. And you'll have your thing. Now, I do all the way around. There is a reason for this, which I'll explain in a bit. Sorry, I keep forgetting my camera isn't quite... because I'm trying to not get belly shots in my daggy clothes. Okay, so that is your wire loop with your pearls. We'll just pop that packet of pearls out of the way and we'll move on to the next step. So you've done your two... you need two of those. So you've done your two your wire loop. It's all finished. It's looking really good. And you've got your beads on your loop. Now, you can see I've already added one here. So there's one already added onto this. And I will show you the way I reshape these. So I had a ruler because I am hopeless at getting things in the same spot. I try really hard and really hard to get everything even. So basically we want it from that first bead, I guess, to be about 4.5 up. So about there. Now, see how we've got the extra wire on this? What we're going to do is we're just going to make sure it's not too tangled. We're going to make sure that it's tight first, because you want your beads, you don't need super tight, because you are going to need a little leeway to put wire through your beads, and that is what I'm going to show you now. So look, I have this bottle of water, and I literally, I'll show you down here because you can't see it, I literally just push the beads onto that just to give them, just to reshape them and just play with them until they're a shape that I like. And I just threw the ear on the floor. Of course I did, because that makes sense when you're doing a tutorial. Let's throw everything on the floor. Oh my god. This is a disaster, but we shall keep going and power on. Okay. So. And I just lost the nice shape that I had to that. But that's okay, because that's one of the last things you really need to worry about is your shape. So what we're going to do is... and I just moved this away to where I was, because I'm so used to doing that. Is we're going to take this excess wire and we're going to wrap it around 2 to 3 beads. Now you might not have enough to do 3 beads, and that is okay. That happens sometimes, and it's not a disaster because I have cut extra wire. So now we're going to do another, we're just going to take it up, bring it over, pull, wrap, pull around. It didn't quite get to 3 beads on either side, but that's okay. Now the thing is, I don't think I got that even spacing. Yeah, I need to move that over, so give me a second. So here's the thing. Got it in the wrong spot? Simple. Just go through with the wire, unlace it, make sure you've got it loose enough that you can move it, and just move it down a little bit. So we have that to that, so we kind of want to be just down a little more. Hang on. Oh, that's a good way to do it. How far are we on there? To there, maybe. Okay, so we're look, it doesn't have to be perfect. You can fiddle with it. I am very bad at not getting things directly symmetrical. I try really hard. Look, I have even measured things and done all sorts of things, but usually if you buy something from my Etsy store, I do try my best to get it very even, but often it's not always perfect. And I guess that's part of being handmade too, is that you're not always going to get things perfect. So I have another piece of wire I cut earlier that is from this. It is 24 gauge wire. I love this stuff. It's powder coated. You get it at Spotlight in a 40-foot reel roll, and they're not fast to chew through. So now what you're going to do is, because I did want 3 on each side, so what I'm going to do is take the wire, you pull, you wrap, and you pull. So 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. Yep, so that's right. So we're doing 3 beads each side, as our anchor points. Now, here's the thing. Yes, I could have done this after I had put the ribbon around the thing, but I have found that if you do a layer of ribbon, now I know you might not want to waste 6 pearls, and that is perfectly okay if you don't want to, if you just want to have this bit down here wire. I just prefer to have the pearls because it gives me a little more space to work on when you're talking about adding embellishments, adding flowers, adding butterflies or whatever you might want to add to your ears. I find that it gives me just that little bit more space to work with, and that is quite good. So then we've got our ears on, so you can see that. And you can kind of pull them up a bit more based on, yeah, so, and then we'll shape them a bit more in a minute. So now we have, I had another piece and I lost it. That's okay, we can cut another piece of ribbon. So you need 2 pieces of ribbon like this, and the reason for this is they are kind of, I don't know what they're called. I'm sure there must be a term for it. Okay, so here's what you do. You grab your lighter and you light the ends of your ribbon. Now this may seem kind of weird, but what it does is it stops it fraying, and I will light the end of the one I just did. It's really simple, just a lighter. Okay. Now, what you're going to do, I'm just using craft glue. If you're a person who likes to use hot glue, you can use hot glue on this step. But what I do is I just put a little bit of glue over this bit. Just, and then these are the start points of wrapping your headband. I literally just take a little bit here and a little bit there, and I just make sure they're on evenly. Now, that's it. Now, you may think that kind of seems like a silly thing to do, but what it does is when you actually finish, like when you've done your wrapping around, it just adds that slightly more finished professional look as far as I'm concerned. But also I have a tendency when I am doing, I just forgot what I was doing then and did it directly onto the